Bidvest is a South Africa-based investment holding company with subsidiaries operating in distribution services and trading businesses and a large food service business in Europe. Bidvest has a market cap of 83.8 billion rand, price to earnings ratio of 16.6, dividend yield of 2.4%, and of course, Brian Joffe, also worthy of mention.
Absolutely. He's the guy that put this whole group together. It's now a global titan, and he's all been down to him. He's spectacularly good at investment allocation decisions, both purchases of business as well as deciding which ones to feed more capital to and to encourage and which to sort of shut down or slim down or shove into some other entity. They've gone global. They bought businesses in Asia and Australia and the UK and continental Europe when everybody else thought that they were just, you know, throwaway operations. Put it all together, they've become and emerged as a global giant in food services. I mean, second only to a couple of people like Sodexo and Cisco and others. So it's a fabulous operation. He himself remains key to it all, but he has evolved and developed further leadership talent around him here in the headquarters in Melrose Arch.
Your history with Bidvest, Gebrand, have you done well from the stock previously?
Yeah, look, this is one of the winners on the local bourse over time. I think return from its started return in, on equity and assets of 20 plus per year, every year, certainly one of the star performers. I think the original business that he bought was Chipkins.
And
then, he's branched out to all other industries as well. You got travel in there, you got Comestec, you got on the auto McCarthy side, they're selling cars, they got logistics, they got a huge food business, as Paul said.
And the big argument is whether there will be value unlock if you break up Bidvest. Paul, you've heard the story
well,
bandied about.
That is one argument, and I think we quite like investments like that because you're right, the sum of the parts in the end obviously could well be greater than the current entity. And that's because the market goes through these cycles of liking and then not liking the conglomerate. At the moment, we're in one of those long eras where people prefer focused entities that they can compare to each other, compare to their global peers. So that's why I think in the long, long run, whether it's in 5 or 10 years' time, it's possible that if Brian is retired, if his successors are of the view more that it's a question of unlocking shareholder value, that they may look at such issues. Because some of those global giants in those industries might come looking for and shopping for those particular businesses and be prepared to pay a substantial premium for them. So definitely not out of the question.
Potential upside to the Bidvest story, Gebrand.
Yeah, look, only time will tell. We think industrial is a bit expensive. 16p is not too expensive for this business, but historically it is a bit on the rich side, probably close to what fair value would be for these companies. But I think if these guys do unbundle their food business, it would certainly probably create a lot of upside. The positive here is that they got more than 50% rand hedge exposure as well, and I think that was what saved their previous results. But certainly you'll probably have to look at the next sets of results first.
And we are expecting a weaker rand, according to all the experts going forward. So that rand hedge quality is important. Hot or not, Paul?
Look, I remember when they were trading at 20 rand a share and people said, well, look, this guy's done well and he's a bright lad, but, you know, who knows what he can do next. Now they're at 260, 10 times higher in about 10 years. So that's a fabulous investment. We've been accumulating these for client portfolios for the last 4 or 5 years. We like them very much. We think it's going higher, even if it does no reorganization and just continues to opportunistically buy bits and pieces of businesses. So definitely for me, hot, definitely fitting into this trend of a rising and improving sectoral exposure. Definitely
Gebrand, hot or not?
Short term not hot, long term hot.
Imperial. Am I allowing you to do that? Let's go with the short term not hot.
Okay, that's fine.